see our first woman finance minister, Madam Nirmala Sitharaman, present the budget. And I would like to congratulate Madam for giving such a wonderful budget. I would like to congratulate our Honorable Prime Minister. I would like to congratulate my friend and MOS, Mr. Anurag Thakur, and the entire team that has been responsible for presenting and bringing about this budget. So I would like to start from a quote by a great poet of India, Sri Rabindranath Tagore. I quote, "We have for over a century been dragged by the over-prosperous West behind its chariot, choked by the dust, deafened by the noise, humbled by our own helplessness, and overwhelmed by the speed. We agreed to acknowledge that this chariot drive was progress, and progress was civilization. If we ever ventured to ask progress towards what and progress for whom, it was considered to be peculiarly and ridiculously oriental to entertain such ideas about the absoluteness of progress. Of late, a voice, Gandhi, has come to us to take count of not only the scientific perfection of the chariot, but of the depths of the ditches lying in its path." I unquote. So at the outset, I would like to say that this budget of 2019-20 is in alignment with the vision and beliefs of the father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi, whose 150 years we are celebrating this year. And therefore, I believe that this is a tribute, this budget is a tribute to our father. So we are at a time where the only way forward is through sustainable development. As has been recognized by Mahatma Gandhi and by Rabindranath Tagore, we cannot follow the Western concept of development. And we have to recognize that the Western model of development in the past has been unsustainable. It has been energy intensive and fuel intensive, and it has been based on overconsumption of non-renewable resources and non-biodegradable resources. We need to focus on sustainability, and I am so grateful to our Honorable Prime Minister and to our Finance Minister for ensuring that this budget focuses on sustainability in this new vision for our new India. Sir, the steps such as focusing on e-vehicles, by setting up of the Jal Shakti Ministry, and by encouraging green technology, especially in PMGSY. I think also the implementation of schemes such as the Ujwala Yojana also enhances energy efficiency, and the plans for organic farming are also very sustainable plans that this government has, and I welcome such initiatives and such plans in the budget. Secondly, sir, in this budget, I would also like to draw your attention to the fact that this budget is trying to improve the well-being of our people. It is trying to improve the quality of life of our people and the basic facilities that the people, that the citizens of this country are entitled to, are being focused on. We see initiatives such as Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, Ujwala, Saubhagya. They all have recognized the importance of basic things that people need in order to improve the quality of life. Sir, the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan has helped improve the safety of our women. The PMAY has given houses to our people. Ujwala has made it more energy efficient, and Saubhagya has improved the health of our women. Thirdly and finally, sir, I would also like to say that the intention of this government through the budget is focus on inclusiveness. The motto that our Honorable Prime Minister spoke about, such as Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Vishwas, and national ambition and regional aspirations. These visions can be seen in many of the schemes that are being focused on in this budget. Har Ghar Jal is one of the very, very important visions of this government, which I would like to be grateful for. And I would reiterate that this scheme be converged with the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana and rainwater harvesting structures be included in PMAY, so that Har Ghar Jal scheme can be done in a more effective and a quicker manner. Sir, 70% approximately of our population lives in rural areas, and therefore the Spurti scheme, which aims to boost the agro industries, is again a very welcome initiative. The Mudra scheme for women, again, is a very, very important initiative. I would like to say I'm very positive, and I believe that I'm very hopeful that this budget is going to be a very good budget. But, sir, there are certain concerns from the Northeast region. Very 1 minute I would take, sir, that I would like to put forth. Sir, though the budget allocation for donor ministry has increased up to 3,000 crores, infrastructure and road infra schemes have also been increased. The Northeast Special Infrastructure Development Scheme has been increased to 695 crores. But, sir, the allocation for NEC has been decreased to 580 crores. Also, the allocation for the central pool of resources for Northeast region and Sikkim has also reduced, sir, to 531 crores. I urge the government to kindly, sir, 1 second, to reconsider and increase the funds for the Northeast Council and for the development of the Northeast region. I also request the government to improve the connectivity infrastructure between Northeast India and Southeast Asia by improving the international roads and air connectivity. Sir, India shares a border with eight countries ke saath hai, aur unme se 4 countries, sir, Northeast ke through connected hoti hai. I would request you, sir, कि अभी हमारे इस बजट में बोला गया है कि 400 करोड़ को ये नए इंस्टीट्यूशंस, जिसको बोलते हैं द इंस्टीट्यूशंस हैव बीन सेट अप फॉर हायर एजुकेशन, एंड आई अर्ज दिस गवर्नमेंट टू काइंडली लुक एट Northeast region, because it is strategically located, and setting up of these institutions in the Northeast would be very helpful to us economically. It will help in our national integration. Also, sir, organic farming was mentioned in the presidential address, but in this budget I was unable to locate the specifications of this proposal, and I would request you to kindly look into that. With these few words, I thank the Honorable Finance Minister for a wonderful budget. I thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak. Thank you very much, sir. Jai.